Good evening, people.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Welcome back.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Good evening. Good evening, Alejandra.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you tonight?
Teacher, good evening.
Good evening, Alejandra. Good to see you again. Hello, Irma.
Hello, teacher.
Good evening. To see you again, Caroline.
Hello.
Yeah. Hilda, Olga, Miguel, and Joanna is coming.
Here.
Welcome back.
Thank you so much.
Hi, Olga. How are you?
Hi, teacher. I'm fine.
Great, very good. Okay. We are ready for the end of the year. I think this is the last module of the year. I think. Ya no creo que tengamos otro módulo este año. Probablemente no. Este sea el último.
Yes.
¿Verdad?
Este va a ser difícil para nosotros, teacher.
Sí, la temporada alta, ¿verdad? Para sí. Algunos de ustedes en sus negocios.
Money.
Yo sufro, teacher, esta temporada. Good evening, teacher.
Money, money.
Money, 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 money.
Yes. Aguinaldo.
Ah, sí, en cambio el teacher. No, pero cae bien el descanso.
Muy pesado, teacher.
Ah.
Entramos a las 6 de la mañana y salimos a las 10 de la noche, matado.
Pero con la bolsa llena.
Pero no queda tiempo de gastárselo.
Ya vendrá.
Después a presumir, teacher, a presumir ellos que tienen money.
Cuando todos regresamos al trabajo, ellos bien galán, descansando.
Yes.
Uno acabado y ellos con plata, teacher.
Ay, 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 dicen que ahí donde lloran está el muerto.
Ajá, vaya Carolina.
No, no, no. Por gusto, Tich.
Y hay algunos que no, nos, los trabajos no son de temporada. Hay algunos que sí, viene la temporada alta. Y le va a tocar pesadito, pero bueno, así es la vida, ¿verdad? Okay, it's good to see you again. Bueno, vamos a comenzar entonces con la primera asistencia, okay? So, please say present. Okay, when I call your name, say present aloud. Oh, hoy nos cambió el orden de la lista. Hoy hicieron de otro modo. Muy bien, comenzamos entonces. Por favor, quiero escucharles su present. Here. Miguel Ángel Domínguez. Miguel Ángel Domínguez.
Present.
Ah, okay.
Present. ¿Me escucha bien, teacher?
Sí, sí, Miguel. Sound and clear. Okay. Olga Marlene Gómez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Claudia Guadalupe Arias. Claudia Guadalupe. Todavía no. Zenaida América Domínguez.
Present, teacher.
Okay.
Nice to
Perfect.
See you.
Nice to see you too. Hilda Xiomara Soriano.
Present, teacher.
Welcome.
Thanks.
Ana Delmi Herrera. Ana Delmi Herrera. Todavía no llega. Alejandra Vanessa Mora.
Present, teacher.
Hey, welcome.
Thanks.
Linda Stephanie Ramírez. Linda Stephanie. Not yet. Okay. Ana Marisol Mendoza.
Present, teacher.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. Nelson Iván Alfaro.
Present, teacher.
Okie dokie, welcome. Carla Verónica Suria.
Present, teacher.
Perfect, very good, welcome. Ángel Alexander Guardado. Ángel Alexander. ¿Cómo está? Y aquí está Irma. Irma de los...
trabajando, teacher. Tienen lleno ahorita.
Ah, vaya, ah, vaya.
Así va a ser yo mañana.
Ok, Irma de Los Ángeles Flores.
Present, teacher.
Hey, welcome. Mayra Roxana Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good. Carlos Alberto Meléndez. Carlos. ¿Cómo está? Carolina Yamilet Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Thank you. Silvia Zuleima Rodríguez. Silvia Zuleima. Todavía no. Silvio Enrique Cortés.
Present.
Very good. Welcome. And Joanna Beatriz Orellana.
Present teacher.
Perfect. Muy bien. Okay. Bienvenidos todos de nuevo. Vamos a iniciar como nos pide INSAFORP con la presentación del curso y los requirements. Okay. Perfect. Just let me share the screen. Share screen. Here. Okay. Course. Ay, no, estos módulos 6. Bueno, vamos. Permítame. Oh, lo pongamos en 6. No. Okay, course English for Work Program Basic Module 6. Este es el curso al que estamos iniciando. Su servidor, profesor en inglés, diplomado en teología, bachiller en química y biología, de ADA de 1900, entonces, cuando existían esos bachilleratos. Experiencia laboral, bueno, facilitador en Regal International desde hace 6 años, profesor de inglés en It Cafe Pade, estuve ahí como 10 años, profesor de inglés en Colegio Elizabeth de Calderón Sol, en el Liceo Hans Christian Andersen, en el Colegio Cuyagualo, y actualmente como intérprete especializado, intérprete médico especializado. Language Line Solutions. Vamos a agregar aquí, le vamos a pedir que me lo agreguen, no me lo han puesto. Ok, ya nos conocemos. Requirements, los requerimientos. Bien, solo recordarles, ya lo saben, ¿verdad? Recordarles. Nombre completo al conectarse a la plataforma, ¿verdad? Vamos a revisar si todos han puesto el nombre completo. A ver, quiero ver. Ajá. Zenaida, Zenaida, no sea tacaña, Zenaida, póngame el nombre completo. Olga también. No se les va a gastar, no se les va a gastar. Ok. Nombre completo, no es requerimiento de INSAFORP. En el caso de oyentes, agregar palabra oyente, no, en este módulo no tenemos oyentes. Ay, esto que cuesta, se le gasta el cel, se le gasta la compu. Cámara encendida durante toda la sesión. Bueno. Ah, ojalá. De módulo mejoremos en esto. Cámara encendida durante toda la sesión. Si son bonitos ustedes, hombre, no se oculten. Ah, no me dejen hablando con pantallas negras. Se siente feo. Ok, lo siguiente, minimizar el sonido ambiente lo más posible, ¿no? Si pueden alejarse del sonido de su casa, de la tele o de lo que esté, pues excelente, se les agradece. Y participación activa, ¿verdad? Como lo hemos tenido siempre, mantenerlo, participación activa. Tratemos en la medida de lo posible de no estar como oyentes en el sentido que me ponen uno, pero teacher, solo voy a estar como oyente, ¿no? En la medida de lo que podamos, tratemos de evitarlo. Yo comprendo, ¿verdad?, las situaciones laborales, pero si lo podemos evitar, sería bueno, porque a la hora de trabajar en grupos, algunos quedan, ¿verdad?, ahí solos, porque el compañero no está participando.
Entonces, eso es parte de la participación activa que se les solicita. ¿Qué más tenemos acá? Bueno, asistencia al 100%. Eso es lo que se les pide, ¿verdad? Por eso estamos en un horario supuestamente factible para todos, ¿verdad? Y que todos sabíamos de estar acá a las 8 de la noche hasta las 10. La asistencia no solamente se toma al estar presente, sino también a cumplir con la clase completa. Recuerde que hay un porcentaje de minutos que INSAFOR les está contabilizando, ¿no? No solo cuenta que ya firmó, que ya marcó, ¿verdad? Sino a través de Zoom se le contabilizan los minutos y hay un mínimo que cumplir. La asistencia se toma en 3 ocasiones. Por cierto, voy a activar mi alarmita de las 9 de la noche porque si no se me olvida. ¿Verdad? Permítame un segundo antes de... Aquí está. Ok. Las 9 de la noche que me esté avisando que debemos de pasar a asistencia. A las 9:55. 3 asistencias. Se tomará como válida al escuchar al participante decir presente y tener presente y tener cámara encendida, ¿verdad? Ay, pero que este módulo mejoremos en eso, por favor. Luego, sesiones 1 a 1 disponibles. Cada participante será asignado 10 minutos al finalizar cada clase para aclarar dudas con su facilitador. ¿Verdad? Aclarar dudas o repasamos, ¿verdad? Lo que hemos visto, practicamos un poco de pronunciación, en fin. La idea es aprovechar esos 10 minutitos, ¿verdad? De alguna manera. Por cierto, ¿verdad? Vamos con el orden de la lista. Entonces, la primera le toca hoy a Miguel Ángel, mañana le tocaría a Olga, ¿ok? Para que estemos ahí hoy, Miguel Ángel, por favor, en la sesión personalizada. Permisos, pues no hay disponibles, ¿verdad? Es decir, si usted, yo sé que a veces algunos me dicen, mire, no voy a poder estar porque estoy en el trabajo, o no voy a poder estar porque cualquier razón válida, no, pero igual no se les puede marcar como asistencia. Siempre les queda como ausencia. ¿Ok? Bien. Tareas y evaluaciones. Es necesario obtener el 80% en promedio de tareas y evaluaciones para poder completar el curso satisfactoriamente. Tareas, sabemos que están en la plataforma justo después de cada clase. Oh, la fecha límite, permítame, está mal, vamos a corregir la fecha límite para, bueno, todas las tareas de los temas ya cubiertos tienen que estar completas antes de cada viernes a la medianoche, ya que este registro es enviado a INSAFOR semanalmente. El midterm para este módulo tiene que estar, hoy estamos 15, el 26. ¿Verdad? El midterm es para noviembre 26 y el examen final para el viernes 10 de diciembre. ¿Ok? O sea, de este viernes al otro es el midterm, noviembre 26 y el examen final el 10 de diciembre. El manual puede ser descargado de la plataforma. También se los han puesto aquí en el grupo de WhatsApp. Y no se utiliza material de terceros, es decir, libros que otros no usan. Para la plataforma, pues, mantener el botón del micrófono en silencio, en mute. Cámara encendida, podemos usar el chat, podemos usar los breakout rooms, es decir, usamos los grupos donde aprovechen para practicar su inglés, no el español ya lo hablan bonito. Es donde deben aprovechar para practicar su inglés. Y, ok, Mayra, Roxana, está levantando la mano. ¿Tiene alguna pregunta?
Yes, teacher. You can include me in the group WhatsApp.
Se les envía un enlace para que se unan al grupo. Yo no soy el administrador del grupo.
Ah, ok.
En el correo debes de tener el enlace. Otra vez ese enlace.
Thank you.
Ok. Bien. Y eso es todo. Eso es todo, amigos. Bien. ¿Alguna pregunta, alguna idea, alguna sugerencia antes de que comencemos este módulo? ¿Verdad?
No, teacher.
¿Estamos?
Yes.
Bueno, perfecto. Como ya nos conocemos, pues nos saltamos las presentaciones, ¿verdad? Ahora, entre todos, ya nos conocemos, no tenemos a nadie nuevo. Ok, arrancamos entonces con el material de esta noche. ¿Ya todos tienen el libro? ¿Ya lo descargaron? ¿Okay?
No.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher. Descárguenlo, pues ahí está en el grupo de WhatsApp, ahí se les envió, ¿verdad? Ahí lo tienen. ¿Ya todos tienen acceso a la plataforma?
Yes.
¿Hay alguien que todavía no?
Yes.
Ya todo, ¿verdad? Perfecto. Fabuloso. Entonces, arranquemos. Bueno, vamos a compartir pantalla. ¿Dónde estamos? Ok, vamos a compartir pantalla para comenzar con la lección de esta noche. Ok, Unit 1's title is Job Listings. Job Listings. Ok, our objective is the following. Vamos a ver, le voy a pedir a Silvio que nos pueda leer el objective for tonight's class.
I will be able, teacher.
Exact.
Okay. Respond to question regarding qualification and potential contribution.
Okay. Very good. Thank you. So you will be able to respond to questions regarding qualifications and potential contributions. Ya vamos a ver qué es eso de qualifications. Okay. Now, a couple of questions here to start. What are some of your abilities? What are some of your abilities? Okay, can you tell me? Let's talk about that. One of my abilities is, well, speak English. That is one of my abilities. Okay, another ability that I have, I can sing, more or less, but I can sing. Another ability that I have, I can cook a little bit. I can cook. I can make rice, scramble eggs, fried eggs. What else? Sandwiches. That's it. Those are some of my abilities. So, about my job. Talking about job, my abilities are, well, basically, I can interpret simultaneously. I can
take notes quickly. That's important in my job. I can remember things, okay. Have a good short-term memory. That's important in my job. So those are some of my abilities. What about you? What are some of your abilities? Who can share? Who can start? Who wants to start? Tell us about your abilities. At least one ability that you have.
I can use Excel 19%.
Oh, okay. Nah, that's good. Use Excel. Okay. Another ability. Somebody else, please.
I can cook.
You can. Oh, yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh. What is your special dish, Hilda?
I don't have a special, but by my family say that I cook good.
Okay, good. Caroline.
My ability is to crochet, embroider, dish, mesh, sew, and jewelry. My favorite is crochet.
Okay, interesting.
Yes.
Very good. I need a sweater. Okay, somebody else. Abilities. Come on, don't be shy.
I can break yet today.
Make the diet. Come on.
Yeah.
That is not an ability. That is a weakness. Es una debilidad. I can do it as well. Okay, so what about you, Marisol? What is one of your abilities? Pues ya se me fueron, ya ven. Ay, no, es que eso es lo malo.
Teacher.
Ajá, Mayra.
I can read between the line. And then I read and analyze fast.
Okay. Interesting. Very good. Okay, so abilities are important. Okay. Let me ask you the question in this way. In your job, what is an important ability for you in your job? The reason that you are in that job is because you have an ability, a particular ability. Yes? Si tú estás en ese trabajo es porque tienes una habilidad. Because of that ability, you are there.
Ability. In my case, I ability analyze number or quantity of the accountant.
Okay. And so
that's interpret the results of the numbers.
Okay. Very important ability. Okay, so tell me about your job.
Teacher, in my case, my ability is talk with the guests because the guests need my help. At the resolution.
Okay, that's an ability. Very good. And Joanna, what is an important ability in your job for you?
In my job, the important abilities are patient people.
Be patient.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good.
And ser, ¿cómo se llama esta cosa? Hábil con los números.
Good with numbers. Be good,
I'm
with,
good
numbers.
With number.
Okay.
I have a good relaciones with the people, with the customers.
Okay. Good relations, relationships. Okay. Hilda, you want to talk?
Yes, teacher. In my case, listen and be very patient with my boss.
With your boss?
Yes.
Okay. What about you, Alejandra? What is your ability to be in that position in your job? Not there. Marisol, are you back?
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
Customer service.
Customer service. Okay, good.
Yes.
What about you, Nelson? What is your ability to be in that job?
In my job, my ability is write fast.
Okay. By hand or on the computer?
In the computer.
Okay, so you type.
Yes.
Type fast. Okay, good. And what about Olga? What is the important ability for you in your job?
I think that my ability is analyze the number and fast type the report, the finance report.
Okay, very good. And Carla?
Yes, teacher. I work in department importation, but the main for me is check the inventory from material and production.
Okay. Good. Very good. Who else? Okay, very good. We're done. Irma, what is the important ability for you in your job?
My ability is countable.
Okay.
So I like the number. I am waitress.
Waitress as well.
Waitress is cook.
And cook. Okay. Very good. Very good. Okay. So when we talk about these abilities for a particular job, is what we call qualifications. Okay. Qualifications are the abilities or knowledge that you need for a particular job. Right? So are your qualifications for this job? I am very responsible. I am good with numbers. I am very friendly with the customers. Etc. Okay, those are your qualifications for a particular job. Okay, very good. Let's continue then. And the other question is, are you a fast learner? Interesting. Are you a fast learner? Raise your hand if you are a fast learner. Do you learn fast or no?
No.
I am a fast learner if I like.
I mean, yes.
Okay. Raise your hand.
Yes.
If I don't like it, I'm not fast. Yeah, if I don't like something, I like it, I'm a fast learner. Okay? It's important because sometimes you need to adapt in your job.
Yes. Companies change. Positions change. And we need to adapt. For example, this, the technology. I'm not a young person. I am almost 60. And I had to learn technology. Okay, to teach online classes, to work online from home. So I had to learn to use technology in the classroom. I had to learn. And I think I'm not that slow. I'm kind of fast to learn. And many people don't adapt. I know a lot of teachers that they, nah, I don't like that. I don't like that. Okay, that's, so fast learner. It is important to be a fast learner in your job. Okay, now let's take a look to the conversation. We have a conversation here, and it says, Ben is in a job interview. Listen to the conversation, okay? Between Andre and Ben. This is a conversation between Andre and Ben. Ben is in a job interview. Okay, listen. Oh, let me record it in WhatsApp so you can practice it later. A moment, and no, it's not. Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera. Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera. We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualifications do you have for this job? Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects, and I am very good at sales. That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets? Can you use them? I can speak little Chinese, but I can't use spreadsheets, but I am a fast learner. I get it. When can you start? Okay, very easy interview, very short. Very good. Now, listen and repeat, please. Let's practice. Okay. Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Hello,
Ben. Hello, Ben. Hello, Ben.
My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras.
What qualifications do you have for this job?
What qualifications do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects, and I am very good at sales.
Well, I can speak English, also I can manage small projects, and I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets? And you use them?
That's great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets?
Can you use them?
parte.
I can speak little Chinese, but I can't use spreadsheets. But I am a fast learner.
I can speak a little Chinese, but I am a fast learner.
I get it. When can you start?
When can you start?
Okay. Very good. Very good. Any question with the conversation?
Teacher, spreadsheets.
Who knows? Who knows the meaning of spreadsheets? ¿Quién sabe?
Excel. Excel.
Ajá. ¿Verdad? Son las hojas de cálculo. Las spreadsheets. ¿Ah? Las hojas de cálculo.
De cálculo.
Uh-huh. Okay. Let's practice one more time. But this time I am Andre and you are Ben.
Ben.
Okay. Ready?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Good. Yes.
I'm ready.
Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualifications do you have for this job?
Well,
I can speak English. I can manage the small projects. I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets? Can you use them?
I can use spreadsheets, but I am a faster learner.
I get it. When can you start? Okay.
When can you start?
Now you are Andre and I am Ben. Okay, so you begin. 1, 2, 3.
Hello, Ben.
Hello, Ben. Welcome. This is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras.
What qualifications do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects. And I am very good at sales.
That's great.
Can't you speak Chinese? What about using spreadsheets? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can't use spreadsheets. But I am a fast learner.
I get it.
When can you start?
Okay, very good. Very good. Okay, now there are two questions here in this conversation. One is, what are some of the qualifications that are required for the position available? And number two, what are the qualifications for the work you do? Hablamos un poquito de eso. Okay, so I will send you to work in pairs. You are going to practice the conversation and respond the questions on exercise 3. Okay? And then we'll come back and you're going to present the conversation. Let me form the groups. We are, okay, in pairs. You're going to work in pairs. Okay, perfect. Todos los grupos, muy bien. So go to your groups, practice the conversation, respond to two questions, and see you in around 10 minutes. Join your groups, please. Your classmates are waiting for you. Oh, Olga, Nelson is waiting for you.
Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English also.
Only speak with the clients is very
good. And write the report. I prepare the schedule for my.
Pero aprendo muy rápido. Fast. Rápido mm-hmm. learner. Aprender.
Mm-hmm. Aprender.
But I am a fast learner.
Okay. Yo aprendo rápido.
Aprender rápido.
Ah, pues me equivoqué porque yo cuando el teacher preguntó de fast learner, yo entendí leer rápido.
Aprenderlo.
Y creí que decía aprender leer rápido el inglés. Pero,
ay, no. Pero no. Ups.
Nelson,
sí.
We are offering a manager position for a branch.
No,
Teacher.
Yes.
I can use the share screen in a in the partner.
La asistencia, teacher.
Yes, I'm going to take the attendance. You want to share the screen, Silvio? Who's
I try to use the book, and I try to use the share screen, and when I put this the message, host disable participates screen sharing. Is the traté de compartir el manual y cuando le di share screen me sale ese mensaje.
Voy a ver qué será porque no he hecho nada de eso.
Ok.
Share screen, ¿qué me dice? Vamos a ver ahí. Okay, I'm going to take the second attendance. So please turn on your cameras and respond. Okay. Let's see. Miguel Ángel Domínguez. Miguel Ángel.
Present.
Okay. Olga Marlene Gómez.
I'm here, teacher.
Good. Claudia Guadalupe Arias.
Present.
Claudia Guadalupe Arias. Yeah. Zenaida America Dominguez.
Present, teacher.
Good. Hilda Xiomara Soriano.
Present, teacher.
Anadelmi Herrera. No. Alejandra Vanessa Mora.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Linda Stephanie Ramirez. No. Ana Marisol Mendoza.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Nelson Iván Alfaro. Nelson Iván Alfaro.
Tu micrófono está fallando. No se te escucha, Nelson.
Sí. Bueno, pero ahí te veo. Okay. Carla Verónica Suria.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ángel Alexander Guardado. Bueno. Irma de Los Ángeles Flores.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Mayra Roxana Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Carlos Alberto Meléndez.
Present.
Good. Carolina Yamilet Hernández.
Present.
Good. Silvia Zuleima Rodríguez. Silvia Zuleima Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Silvia Enrique Cortés.
Present.
Okay, Joana Beatriz Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good. Okay, let's see. I'd like to hear your conversation, to see your pronunciation, and okay, let's see. Let's start with group number one, which is Ana Marisol and Silvia Zuleima, please. Ready,
set, okay.
Go.
Give me a second, please. Okay, hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andres Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage a small and big project, and I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using a spreadsheet? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can't use a spreadsheet. But I am a fast learner.
I get it. When can you start?
Okay, very good. Thank you. Now, group number two is Carlos and Zenaida. Lights, camera, action.
Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Sandro Rivera.
One moment, please, because I didn't have the...
Teacher, please come share your model.
Hello.
Okay. Yeah.
Again, hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We're offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage a small and big projects, and I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can use spreadsheets, but I am a fast learner.
I get it. When can you start?
Okay, very good. Thank you. Group number three, Caroline and Joanna. Lights, okay. Camera, action.
Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage a small and big project. And I'm very good at sales.
That's so great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using a spreadsheet? Can you use them?
I can speak a little Chinese, but I can't use spreadsheets. But I am a fast learner.
I get it. When can you start?
Hey, very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, group number four, Carla and Silvio.
Okay. Hello, Ben, and welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects, and I am very good at solving.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can use spreadsheets. But I am a fast learner.
I get it. When can you start?
Okay, perfect. Very good. Now let's continue with Irma and Myra.
Okay.
Okay. Hello, Ben. I welcome. My name is Andrea Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage a small and big project, and I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese?
Yeah.
And what about using a spreadsheet? Can you see them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can't use spreadsheets. But I am a fast learner.
I get it. We can do a start.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Now, group number 7. Oh, I'm sorry, there are Alejandra, Xiomara, and Miguel Angel.
Okay, teacher.
A ver, ¿cómo lo hacemos?
Uno cada uno.
Okay, Alejandra and Xiomara, comienza.
Okay. Hello, Ben. And welcome. Sorry.
Xiomara?
Yes, teacher, I'm here.
Okay. Listen,
okay. Good. Okay. Hello, Ben. And welcome. My name is Andrea Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage a small and big projects, and I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using spreadsheets? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can use spreadsheets. But I am fast learner.
I get it. When can you start?
Hey, very good, very good. A ver, Miguel. ¿Con quién practica ponemos a Miguel?
Hi, teacher.
Escoja usted su partner, Miguel, de cualquiera del grupo, de la clase.
Okay,
I am here.
Zenaida.
Bye. Yes. Sister.
Okay, Zenaida wants to practice with you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Go, sister.
One moment, please.
Okay.
Okay. Miguel, go ahead.
Hello. Okay. Right. Hello, Ben. Welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects. And I am very good at sales.
Oh, great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about using a spreadsheet? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can use a spreadsheet, but I am a fast learner.
I get it. So it's tough.
Okay, thank you. And finally, group number 8 with Nelson and Olga.
Okay, thank you, sister. Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Nelson?
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. You start.
Hello, Ben. And welcome. My name is Andre Rivera.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Rivera.
We are offering a manager position for a branch in Honduras. What qualification do you have for this job?
Well, I can speak English. Also, I can manage small and big projects, and I am very good at sales.
That sounds great. Can you speak Chinese? And what about you? Can you use them?
I can speak little Chinese, but I can't use spreadsheets, but I am a fast learner.
I got it. When can you start?
Right now.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much. Okay, let's see some words that we need to practice, we need to reinforce, okay? La que veo que más problema les dio es esta. Okay. Para la pronunciación podemos separar, solo por fines de pronunciación. Spread, spreadsheets.
Spreadsheets.
Sí, spreadsheets. Están viendo la pizarra, ¿verdad?
¿Sí? Yes.
Okay. Please repeat after me. Spreadsheets.
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 Yes. Spread. Spread.
Spread.
Spreadsheets.
Sheets.
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 Okay. Sheets. Yeah.
Spreadsheets.
Be careful with that pronunciation, okay? No, it's going to be shit. No. No. Okay. Sheets. Okay. Spreadsheets. Muy bien.
Spreadsheets.
Yes. La otra es esta. Varios les dio problemita. Sales.
Sales.
Sales. Okay. Repeat, please. Sales.
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 Mm-hmm. Sales.
Sales.
Yes. La otra que es esta, porque no, bueno, la pronunciaron en español, no la mayoría, pero recuerden que en inglés la H no es muda. En inglés, ¿qué sonido tiene usualmente la H?
J.
Como J, ¿verdad? Por eso decimos horse, hotel, hospital, en la mayoría de los casos, no siempre, mayoría de los casos, ¿ok? Y por eso usualmente este es Honduras, ¿no? Los americanos van a decir Honduras, ¿ok? Otra que no todos, pero uno que otro, ¿verdad? Les dio problemita es sounds. Great.
Sounds great.
Sounds great.
Right.
Ahorita, ¿verdad? Great. Y algunos dicen great, otros great. Es great.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Great. Sounds great. ¿Verdad? Sounds great.
Great.
Y todo lo demás, muy bien, muy bien. Pronunciación, muy bien. Ok. Así es que practicamos estas rápidamente, ¿no? Repeat. Spreadsheets.
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 Sales.
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 Okay. Honduras.
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 Sounds great.
Sounds great.
Sounds great.
Sounds great.
Sounds great.
Okay. Very good. Very good. Okay. Now, let's continue then. Here. Okay, there are two questions. What are some of the qualifications that are required for the position available? Okay, what are some of the qualifications?
Speak Chinese.
I can speak like Chinese and use a spreadsheet.
Okay, use spreadsheets. Okay.
Spreadsheets.
Use speak Chinese. Use spreadsheets. Okay, very good. And what are the qualifications for the work you do? Bueno, solo hablamos un poco. So, when we are talking about abilities, we can use can to talk about abilities. Okay? Let's read here. Use can when you want to name your abilities. Use can't when you don't know how to do something. I can speak three languages. I can use spreadsheets, but I learn fast. I can direct small projects. I can use this program. I am a fast learner. Okay? I want you to notice the pronunciation. So, because sometimes it's difficult to make a difference if you are talking in negative or affirmative, okay? But in affirmative sentences, the emphasis, the stress is here on the verb. I can speak three languages. I can direct small projects. Vean, en las oraciones afirmativas, la fuerza de voz va ¿a dónde?
The vowel.
The verb.
In the verb.
The verb. Va en el verbo. Okay. I can speak three languages. I can direct small projects. I can cook lasagna. Okay. I can play the guitar. I can swim very well. So, la fuerza va en el verbo. Hay que afinar mucho el oído para eso, ¿verdad? Para llegar a esa diferencia, porque hablando rápido a veces usted puede decir qué me dijo, qué puede o qué no puede. ¿verdad? Pero por ahí nos puede ayudar esto, ¿no? Y in the negative sentences, the stress is on can't. Digo a la fuerza. I can use spreadsheets. I can use this program. Okay. Entonces hay que tratar de escuchar eso para saber si están diciendo, porque a la hora de hablar usualmente se va a usar esta forma contractada, ¿no? I can't. De hecho hay tres formas para el can, ¿verdad? Bueno, la forma completa que es I cannot. Por ejemplo, I cannot. Speak Chinese, por ejemplo. Or I can't Chinese. Y hay otra forma que es I cannot. Y también pueden verlo en alguna ocasión unido. I cannot be Chinese. ¿Ah? Pero de esto lo más común es esto. En el inglés hablado, ¿no? A la hora de estar hablando. Es el más común. ¿Ok? Bien. Entonces hay que aprender a afinar un poquito el oído para escuchar dónde va la fuerza. Si va en el verbo o va en el can't. ¿Ok? En las afirmativas, repito, la fuerza va en el verbo y en las negativas va en el can't. Okay. ¿Ok? ¿Alguna pregunta con esto?
No, teacher.
No. Muy bien. Entonces, we have this exercise. But I also have something to show. Let me ayudar a reforzar un poco esto. A silenciarlos un momento porque hay por ahí un ruidito. Igual, ¿verdad? Simplemente repasar esto de otra manera, ¿no? El uso del can y como ven aquí, cannot. ¿Verdad? So, repito lo que mencionamos. Luego les comparto esta imagen para que la tengan ahí también. We use can for ability or possibility. Y también we can use can for permission. Yeah. So, can I go to the bathroom? Yes. Okay. Esa es una para permiso, ¿no? La estructura, recordemos, can más el verbo. Y el verbo in the base form. He can speak English. Es lo correcto. He can speaks English. Esto no es correcto. No se usa la S de la tercera persona. Y tampoco es correcto. He can to speak English. No, eso no es correcto. Solo usamos el verbo en su forma básica. He can speak. I can speak. You can speak. We can speak, they can speak. Okay. Y lo que ya vimos acá, el singular, el affirmative, singular. I can speak English, I can't speak French. You can ride a bike, you can't ride a horse. He can drive a car, he can't drive a truck. He can play the guitar, she can't play the piano. It can swim, it can fly. We can play football, we can't play tennis. You can see the stars, you can't see germs. They can dance, they can't sing. Y acá la contracción del cannot. Questions. ¿Cómo se forman las questions? Bueno, como hemos dicho siempre, invirtiendo el orden de las oraciones afirmativas, ¿verdad? Para formar una pregunta. Por ejemplo, they can speak Spanish. Question, can they speak Spanish? Yes, they can. No, they can't. Okay. Estas son preguntas de sí o no, ¿verdad? Can they speak Spanish? Yes, they can. No, they can't. Y lo que les mencionaba, la contracción puede ser can't o puede ser cannot. He can't sing, he cannot sing. Unido. ¿Verdad? ¿Alguna pregunta con este otro cuadro?
No, teacher.
It's clear, teacher.
No, teacher.
Okay. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. Hagamos una cosa, practiquemos estas oraciones para practicar esa entonación que les digo, donde en la affirmative el énfasis va en el verbo y en las negative el énfasis va en el can. ¿Ok? So, repeat after me, please. I can speak English.
I can speak English.
And speak French.
And speak French.
You can ride a bike.
You can ride a bike.
You can ride a horse.
You can ride a horse.
He can drive a car.
He can drive a car.
He can drive a truck.
He can play the guitar.
He can play the guitar.
He can play the piano.
It can swim.
No, I'm sorry. It can swim.
It can swim.
It can fly.
It can fly.
We can play football.
We can play football.
We can't play tennis.
We can't play tennis.
You can see the stars.
You can see the stars.
You can't see germs.
You can see germs.
They can dance. They can't sing. Okay, very good. Déjenme les comparto esa imagen ahí en el WhatsApp para que lo tengan.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, in your books, you have a couple of exercises, some sentences here. Complete the sentences with the appropriate form of can, okay? Es que les doy un par de minutos para que hagan esto individualmente, usando can or can't. Go ahead. Trabajen, por favor. Okay, did you finish?
Yes, teacher.
Finished, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Okay, let's see. Okay, Nelson, could you read number one, please?
Okay. I'm sorry. I can't help you today. I'm really busy.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Marisol, can you read number two?
Yes. I just can't manage to wake up on time. I'm always late.
Okay. Let's see, Alejandra, can you read number three?
Is can.
Okay, read the complete sentence.
Okay, look, it's right there. Can you see it? It's so obvious.
Okay. Can or can't?
Can't.
Affirmative or negative, Alejandra?
Affirmative.
What do you think, people? Can you see it?
For me, negative.
Yeah, it could be negative.
Can. Positive.
For teacher.
De hecho, que las dos formas pegarían, ¿verdad? Can you, lo puedes ver?
Yes.
No, obvious. Aunque quizá más negativo, porque el énfasis queda al final. But, can you see it? It's so obvious. No, puedes ver, es tan obvio. I would say can't, but okay. No problem. Number four, let's see, Miguel, can you read number four?
Yeah, I can speak German. I live in Germany for 8 years.
Okay, very good. And number five, let me ask to Senaida, can you read number five?
She doesn't have a driving license. She can't drive a car.
Okay, very good, very good. Okay, so number one, negative. Yes?
Yes.
Number two,
negative.
Number three, for me, is negative. Number four, affirmative. Number five, negative. Okay. Okay, let's practice pronunciation. Okay, repeat after me. I'm sorry, I can't help you today. I'm really busy. Repeat.
I'm really busy.
Okay.
Busy.
Busy. Es raro, ¿verdad? Pero así se pronuncia. Busy. Okay. Number two. I just can't manage to wake up on time. I'm always late.
I just can't manage to wake up on time. I'm always late.
Good. Three. Look, it's right there. Can't you see it? It's so obvious.
Look.
Right there. Can't you see it? It's so obvious.
Four. I can speak German. I lived in Germany for 8 years.
I can speak German for 8 years.
5. She doesn't have a driving license. She can't drive a car.
She doesn't have a driving license. She can't drive a car.
Okay. Very good. Now, here is a diagram about things that you can do and things that you cannot do. Okay. Write about 3 things you can do. And write about 3 things you cannot do. And then you're going to talk with your some classmates about your abilities. Okay? So write 3 things you can do and 3 things you cannot do. Give you 5 minutes to work on that. Y luego los voy a enviar a los grupos para que platiquen de las cosas que pueden y no pueden hacer. Ok. Cuando terminen de escribir sus abilities, levanta la manito para saber que ya están listos. Raise your hand.
Mami se acostó y no cerró.
Okay. Are your abilities? Did you finish? Just waiting for your hands up.
Yes, teacher.
Finish, teacher.
No me pone la manita, no se ve. Ah, okay. Okay, good, very good. Well, we don't have time to go to the breakout rooms again to practice this, so we're going to do it tomorrow. I'm going to take the last attendance. And Miguel, remember that you have the personal session at the end of the class. Okay, Miguel? Muy bien.
The ability.
Okay. No. I was solo estaba diciendo que usted se queda la sesión personal, Miguel. Voy a tomar la tercera asistencia. Okay. Ready, people? Okay, Miguel Ángel Domínguez. Miguel Ángel Domínguez, please say present. Miguel. Miguel Ángel Domínguez, diga presente, por favor. No fue. Olga Marlene Gómez.
Present.
Thank you. Have a good night. See you tomorrow.
See you. Good night.
Amelia Guadalupe didn't show up. Zenaida America Dominguez.
Present teacher.
Very good.
Good night.
Good night. See you tomorrow. Hilda Xiomara Soriano.
Present teacher.
Perfect. See you tomorrow, Hilda. Have a good night.
See you tomorrow, teacher. Good night.
Ana Delmi Herrera didn't show up today. Alejandra Vanessa Mora.
Present teacher.
Okay. See you tomorrow, Alejandra. Good night.
Good night.
Linda right. Stephanie Ramirez didn't show up. Ana Marisol Mendoza.
Present teacher.
Thank you, Ana Marisol. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Nelson Iván Alfaro.
Present teacher.
Okay, have a good night. See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Carla Verónica Zuria.
Present teacher.
Good night, Carla. See you tomorrow.
Good night, see you.
Ángel Alexander Guardado is not here. Irma de Los Ángeles Flores.
Present teacher.
Okay.
Good
Thank
night.
You. Good night, Irma. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, teacher.
Mayra Roxana Hernandez.
Present.
Okay. Have a good night. See you tomorrow.
Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow.
Carlos Alberto Meléndez.
Present.
Perfect. See you tomorrow, Carlos. Good night. Carolina Yamilet Hernandez.
Present teacher.
Thank Good you. Night. Good night. Silvia Zuleima Rodriguez.
Present teacher.
Okay. Very good. Good night. Silvia Enrique Cortez.
Present.
Okay. Good night, Silvio. See you tomorrow.
Good night.
And Joanna Beatriz Orellana.
Present teacher.
Okay, have a good night.
Thank you, teacher.
Ok, parece que al final de la clase el alumno que se iba a quedar en la sesión personalizada tuvo problemas con el internet y se desconectó. Así es que bueno, estaré por acá. Ya le escribí a ver si se puede conectar de regreso.